Welcome, everyone. This is Sandra Alexei, and I am from My Personal News, which is my website underneath that tells you everything about me in the Show Me section. I'm actually a muse. I'm an educator. I am an author. I'm an intuitive astrologer and numerologist. And I also have a new website coming out because I have a new book. And it will launch at the same time. But you can go on My Personal Muse and you'll see the books that I have written, in fact. So what I'm going to do for you today is I want to share what's happening in August. We're halfway through, a little bit more than halfway through 2024. Energies are ramping up, major, major changes. I'm sure everybody's feeling them. There's a lot of tiredness, irritability, just lots of things going on, okay? I also have a Facebook page, and a lot of people like to go on the Facebook page because they can print off my article, and then they can see the different dates, okay? So I'd appreciate it if you'd like, if you'd comment and share this. And what we're going to talk about today is August. I've already done one, and that was on the Saturn-Jupiter square. And it's very close to the moon, but I wanted to do it separately for the moon. So we have a full moon at 27 degrees of Aquarius on August the 19th. Now, the intensity of this is it's the last full moon before eclipse season. So see the dates of eclipse season before, because the energies will be very intense. Mercury also went retrograde at 4 degrees of Virgo on August the 4th until August the 28th, when it goes direct at 21 degrees of Leo. It actually went retrograde at 29 degrees of Leo on August the 16th. So it's very important that if you have your personal astrology chart, find out what house or houses Mercury in Virgo will be in, what house or houses this moon in Aquarius is in, then what house the lunar eclipse in Pisces is in, and finally, what house the solar eclipse is in Libra. It's also a great time to actually have a reading done. You can see that on my website. Now, the seeds of change are planted at this full moon before eclipse season. Huge transformation energy, and it is time for you to stop. It's finally time to stop and see what is really going on, and time to flow with what is coming. Having patience and faith in your personal dharma will have you accept what is and move forward with the lesson of maturity. The personal message for you is to be present in the now to whatever is showing up for you. Okay, now eclipse season. Eclipses are dramatic wild cards in our horoscopes that we don't see coming. They shake us up so that we can move from one level of maturity to another very rapidly. They will provide whatever we need to get moving. They'll provide a competitor, a rival, a critic, a benefactor, funding, or some other force that get us to think, decide, or change. If you have become complacent or took someone or something for granted, chances are that we won't after an eclipse is over and has delivered its message. An eclipse will always give you precisely what you need to advance and evolve. They look for the weak links in all circumstances and instantly and urgently bring information so that you actually can get to decide what you're going to do. That's choices. So September 17th, we will experience a lunar eclipse at 25 degrees of Pisces. The effect of a lunar eclipse can last up to 3 months. This can be a somber but cleansing and healing time, or a joyous and birthing time. Eclipses get their bad reputation because humans are creatures of habit and become upset by unexpected change. If you have been stubbornly resisting growth, then yes, you could experience this lunar eclipse as very volcanic, some violent energy that desperately needs to be purged, but it really shouldn't be dreaded. Then, on October the 2nd, 2024, we will experience a solar eclipse at 10 degrees of Libra. Now, a solar eclipse is a turbocharged new moon. Generally, new moon rituals are perfect for planting seeds and starting afresh. We're working essentially on a blank canvas of the dark moon where our ideas can gestate in the new moon soil. It breaks our habitual behavior and gives us a kind of cosmic reboot. The moon blots out masculine and left brain energy for a while, so that the feminine right brain is flooded with instinctual, intuitive energy. This makes the unconscious conscious, like when you become aware that you're dreaming. During an eclipse like the lucid dream, we get that same feeling of hyper awareness. We could do anything. Sometimes this is so awesome that we don't know what to do. Others even become afraid of their own power. Most times, but I found all of the time for me, the divine knows best and alerts me and you, especially with this Aquarius full moon, which is ruled by the planet Uranus, which shakens you awake. You may feel moody, irrational, as you're sensing a surprise, an unexpected direction, some shocking information, which reveals what's no longer stable or working in your life. The volatile, unnerving energy may feel too confronting. However, it is here for you to take off the rose-colored glasses so you can move forward in life with awakening to the truth and new freedom rather than staying stuck. As you awaken to the higher state of consciousness so your soul can find peace, knowing a higher state of consciousness, a new way of being so that you can actually move forward. As you call your spirit back home and now align with the divine, you will learn to appreciate and trust what you have known all along, taking back your personal power as opposed to giving it to someone else. Reclaim your sovereignty and trust your personal emotional honesty that you have awakened to. It's time to nourish and to tend to your own soul. I always say it's like the eight. And we're in an eight year, is the top part of the eight is non-physical world. Okay, that's the spirit, that's what I listen to. And my bottom part of the eight is my body. And so we align and then we listen. So the universe is assisting you and taking care of you, a time out for you to watch and observe. Be mindful, listen, and get out of la-la land. Big shifts this year. As we have moved into the second half of 2024, prepare for more truth being revealed, and it may be shocking. Hope you enjoyed it and found something that resonated with you. Dare to dream, live your passion, your dharma, align with the divine, and you will know. Many blessings and much love. And as I said, I'd appreciate a like, a comment, a share. And you can check out my Facebook page. It's under Sandra Alexei. And I have the different posts there that you can print off. Many blessings. And you may want to think of having a session or reading with me. And all the information is on the website, mypersonalmuse.com. Many blessings. Much love.